Hello friends, welcome to my channel Dev's Institute. Today we are going to learn 8051 interfacing with keyboard. Before I start, I request you to subscribe to my channel by clicking subscribe button given below the video and click on bell icon to get instant notifications. It's absolutely free of cost. This is a matrix form of a keyboard where the keys are arranged in a matrix form. Such arrangements of keys is done to so that the keyboard can be interfaced or keyboard can be managed with less number of lines. Here we have used 4x4 keyboard. It contains total 16 pins. These pins are interfaced in a row and column fashion. Port 1, 4 rows are connected to port 1 and port 1 is a output port on a microcontroller. 4 columns are connected to port 2, which is input port of a microcontroller. So we are going to set values through this port 1 and we are going to read values through port 2 to check whether any key is pressed, and if it is pressed, then which key is pressed. Okay, so to identify this, first all rows are connected to ground, so we have 0000 at port 1 and all columns are connected to VCC, so we have 1111. When any key is pressed, let's say when key 1 is pressed, then this D0 line from port 1 and D1 line from port 2 will get shorted, and because of this high ground connection, this D1 input becomes 0. So to identify whether key is pressed or not, we will continuously check for these values on port 2. If you find any zero value on port 2, it means that any key on that line is pressed. Okay, so now we'll see how the keys pressed can be identified. So consider that key number 6 is pressed. Okay, so as key 6 is pressed, this D1 line and D2 line will get shorted, and this D2 will get the 0, means D2 will be get connection to ground. So D2 will become 0. We will be continuously reading port 2 and we identify that there is 0 on D2 line of port 2. So port 2 reads as 1011. As there is 0 on D2, we identify that any key on the D2 column is pressed, but we don't know whether it is 2, 6, A or E. Okay, so now next job is to identify a particular row from which the key is pressed. Now we identified the column, but now we have to identify the row. To identify row, what we'll do, we'll make these rows, all rows 1 except one row, and we'll make 1x1 all rows 1x1 zeros. Okay, so now let's see here. First D0 line is connected to ground and rest all are connected to VCC. It is output port, so you can do that very easily. D0 is made 0 and D1, D2, D3 are made 1. So though this is made 0, there is no connection, there is no lines short here, so all values will be 1111 at port 2. Next we'll make this line 0 and rest all three lines 1. So when we make this line 0, then immediately D2 becomes 0. So by this way we can identify that a key is pressed which is on interface of D1 row and D2 column, and that is nothing but the key number 6. So this is how the key is identified in matrix keyboard format. So here you can extend this matrix formation up to 8 by 8. So there you can interface 64 keys. Okay, so next is the interfacing diagram. Here 8 rows are connected to port 0, 8 rows are connected to port P1, and 8 columns are connected to port P1, 8 rows are connected to port P0. First, all they are made 0 by making this port P0 output port. So they are connected to P0.0 to P0.7. Here port P1 is connected to P1.0 to P1.7. This is your 8051 IC. Then port 2 is connected to the output operation, and they are connected to the 7 segment display. So our main focus is here interfacing this matrix keyboard with the ports in 8051. So this is all about how matrix keyboard works and how key pressed is identified in the matrix keyboard. I hope you have understood concept. If you like my video, please press like button given below the video. If you have any queries, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you.